This is how you mix an 808 and kick so they don't clash. First of all, just letting you know, I'm not going to be using any sort of sidechaining or any effect like that. I'm making trap music and rap music. This whole genre is built on distortion, so we're going to use it. But if you're making something like house music, dance music, you might want to sidechain your stuff. At the end of the video, I'm also going to show you how to give your 808 a kick without adding a kick on top. So let's get right into it. Let's say I have the spins 808 and a simple drum pattern. First of all, I have the fruity soft clipper on the drums. That's automatic, so it gives us that nice distortion. Now if I add a kick on top of that, it's gonna sound like this. Even though it sounds super hard, it's just a bit more distorted than I'd like it to be. There's a couple things you can do, but the first thing is shift the 808. So if you shift it here, the sample is just gonna get triggered right a couple of milliseconds after. And then let's say if you add the kick, it sounds a bit better already. The second thing you can do is just raise the out of the kick sample, just to make the kick a bit shorter. The third thing you can do, reverse the polarity. So already you hear the kick way more. Let's play everything together. And you can play with all of those settings until you get that perfect mix. One thing that I always do for my spins 808 or any 808 that I'm using, I play with the envelope just to give it a bit of a kick. The way you do this is you put everything down and you try to figure out the hold. Try to just make a kick with the 808. So usually for me, it's at 7% if you look right next to the FL Studio panel there on the top left. So I usually have it at 7% and then I raise the suspense. Right now, you're making a kick that's embedded in the 808, which I really like to use. And then you can just raise the tail of the 808 until you like it. So like that, instead of being this fully distorted, it still gives you that initial energy with the kick, but then the tail is just a bit lower. And then if you want, you can even add the 808 on top of that, which that's what I do. This is usually the perfect combo for me. Another thing you can do is add something else instead of the kick, like a stomp. And that's it, guys. I hope this video helped. Talk to you soon.